welcome to Surreal's Underground Comics Classics of the Month. I am Surreal, and this is my show. This month, in October of 2006, we are featuring Harold Hedd. Harold Hedd is ahead. He was really into it. He was into it back when drugs were funny, man. He's a really cool guy. I identify with Harold Hedd in a lot of ways. Along with Harold Hedd, we have his little cousin, Elmo. Yeah, Elmo was a warlord for the Owl's Eye Anus Eaters motorcycle gang. He's a bad dude and just a lot of fun to be with. Along with Harold Hedd, we have Harold Head's cat, hey! And Harold Hedd's nemesis is Corporal Leroy of the RCMP. For those of you who aren't internationally flavored, that stands for the Royal Canadian Mounted Police. In my opinion, Harold Hedd was Canada's answer to the fabulous Furry Freak Brothers. You can see there was a lot of correlations there, but there were a lot of differences too. That's what made Harold Hedd unique. Rand Holmes was the artist. Back in 1972, he started submitting single-page strips to a newspaper collective called the Georgia Strait in Vancouver, British Columbia, Canada. He was getting paid $10 a page for these things. And Harold Hedd became very popular. So popular, in fact, that in 1972, the Georgia Strait published the first Harold Hedd comic. Hey, a large, oversized comic. It's gone through about, let's see, what, 7 editions now that I'm aware of? And just took off. It was a whole collection of all the strips that were published at the Georgia Strait. In 1973, Rand Holmes moved down to San Francisco to be with the hippie movement where underground comics were being created. He wanted to, feel like he was being a part of it. And in 1973, Last Gasp published Harold Hedd number 2. Hey! This is actually one of my most favorite stories. This comic is not a collection of little one-pager stories. This one is a whole story by itself called Wings Over Tijuana. A really exciting story. It's got a lot of action. It's got a lot of drugs. It's just really a good story. Definitely on my must-read list. Definite. About 11 years later, 1984. Kitchen Sink published 2 more Harold Hedd comics, interestingly enough, labeling those Harold Hedd number 1 and Harold Hedd number 2. This was a twofer, covering one story called Hitler's Cocaine. A little bit of history and a little bit of action and a good story. And it's in color too, like the old 4-color process. So that's kind of the history of Harold Hedd. Pick it up when you can. Pick it up when you can't. It's definitely something that is a plus to anybody's collection. Well, I guess that's it for this month's show. Tune in next month. We'll do something else. We'll talk to you later, man. Rock on.